Once upon a time, when the world was not so very much younger than it is now, there was a boy named Kyriakos. Kyriakos lived in a little village in Greece with his mother and his old grandfather. They and their neighbors worked hard all day in the fields, but none so hard as those who had no animals to help them. Kyriakos liked pets. He was on the best of terms with half the barnyard animals in the village. He had a goat of his own named Aspasia and a dog named Hero. He knew the way to make friends with anything on four legs. The neighbors used to say he could talk to animals in their own language, but of course we all know better than that. Now, there was one thing Kyriakos wanted more than anything else in the world, and that was a donkey. He had even decided on its name, Kula. Some of the neighbors had donkeys, but his family had lost all their livestock in the war, the same war his father had been killed in. Kyriakos had hopes of getting one, or at least a mule, because he knew the Marshall Plan was sending lots of them from America to Greece. Months before, a committee had met in the village, and Kyriakos' grandfather had gone down along with a lot of others. Each one in turn was given a chance to explain to the committee how much he needed an animal to help with his work. Those whose need was judged greatest were to have their names put on a list, and in time they would get their animals. Kyriakos' grandfather was picked, among others, and his name was written down. But then, nothing had happened. Grandfather had had a feeling from the very beginning that the whole thing was too good to be true. So after a while, he just dismissed it from his mind. But not Kyriakos. Grandfather's name all written out in plain sight. He and three other men from the village were to have mules, all the way from America. Miles away in Kavala, the nearest port, A ship was docked at that very moment. Though Kiriakos, of course, didn't know it. The ship had already begun to discharge its cargo. Hundreds of mules from Missouri and Arkansas, from Texas and Oklahoma and Mississippi. Aboard ship, the captain and some American officials were going through the formalities of turning over the cargo to the Greek government. Unloading the mules was a long, hard task for the dockhands. American mules are not at all like the docile little donkeys most people in Greece are used to. They are as big and powerful as horses, and much harder to handle. And these particular mules were at their very worst after the long trip across the ocean and the frightening process of unloading. Once unloaded, the mules were shipped off in big trucks to different places for distribution. Those for Kiriakos' village, along with many others, set out for Xanthi, where the men of the village were to go and claim them on the day appointed. By dawn of the great day, Kiriakos' mother and sister were up and about, getting the men ready for their journey. For Xanthi was many miles away. Kiriakos could hardly contain himself because grandfather had consented to let him go along. The trip promised to be a great adventure. The men would not be back for at least 2 days, and hardly anyone in the family had ever been that far away from home before. The four men of the village who had been allotted mules were all traveling together, partly because they had only been able to borrow one wagon, and partly because they liked company. The journey was long and slow, and night overtook them on the way. Next day, the sun was already high in the sky. Kiriakos had never seen such a big city. He would have liked to spend hours just walking the streets, looking at the shops filled with all manner of things. big enclosure where the mules were tied up, Grandfather left Kiriakis to go see about the papers to be filled out. Kiriakis had been told to stay right there. But one look at the mules, so different from anything he had ever seen, and Kiriakis forgot his instructions. The more he looked at those strange big animals, the more he liked them. And there stood one in particular. He knew it at a glance. Its name could only be Kula. The big, powerful mules looked anything but reassuring to the farmers who were going to have to handle them. And when Kiriakis pointed out Kula, Grandfather was not at all sure but what this beast looked even bigger and more skittish than the others. The choice of mules was not up to Grandfather or any of the other men. Everyone was to draw his mule by lot. From a hat filled with slips of paper, each man in turn was to take out a slip, and the mule whose number was written on it was to be his. Grandfather's turn was fourth. Kiriakis held his breath as the drawing began. The first man drew. It was not Kula's number. The second man, 7209. Kula was gone. Kiriakis had never wanted anything so much in all his life, but there was nothing he could do but watch Kula being led away. If Kiriakis could do nothing, however, there were those who could. Farmers were all good-hearted men and sorry for Kiriakis. And besides, the one who had drawn Kula was none too pleased with such a spirited animal. So exchanging slips was the work of a moment or two. When Kiriakis found out, you can just imagine how he felt. Everything was not perfect for Kiriakis, though. Grandfather insisted on taking charge of Kula himself, on the grounds that so dangerous an animal should not be entrusted to a boy. Still, there was Kula. So the men of the village at last had their animals, and they should have been very happy, but they were not. The mules had been broken in before they left America, they were still upset. They were frightened and angry, and so were the farmers. There was one in the village, though, who was not.
Εγώ ξέρω πώς να μεταχειριστώ το πουλί, εγώ ξέρω.
Όχι, είσαι πολύ μικρό. Αυτό είναι ένα επικίνδυνο ζώο.
Μα ο κούλης με γνωρίζει. Τρομπο, 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 μες στο πηγάδι και βγάλε. Φόνη μεγάλη, τρομπο, 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 τα βραχιόλια της βροντού.
Thank you.
that day on, there was no further question of whether Kiriakas was big enough to handle Kula, or any other mule for that matter. The others had not yet learned that these mules, being different from the donkeys they were used to, had to be treated differently. If they weren't given water and other things when they needed them, they could be very stubborn and hard to get along with, just like people. His way with mules, Kiriakas had not yet come to terms with Kula on the most important point of all, plowing. The warm spring weather seemed to have gotten into Kula's blood. He was listless and uninterested. He refused to concentrate on his work. Once, Kiriakas' way with animals seemed to have failed him. He was at his wit's end. Then suddenly he had an idea. An idea not soon to be forgotten in the village. Kiriakas had decided that Kula was just lonesome. What he wanted was some company, a more experienced friend to help show him what to do. For a while, it was a delicate situation. Kula liked it very much, but his little teammate was not quite so sure. Things were still not going quite right, but by now Kiriakas knew that he had regained his touch. Plowing went well after all, and up and down the countryside, as farmers learned to handle their new American mules, their lives became just a little easier, their farms became just a little more productive, and Greece itself became just a little happier land to live in.